We are fighting algae since 2009. That was the year that Green Aqua was founded. And why do we need to fight algae? Because a lot of ammonia and a lot of light causes algae. And why? Because plants do not get what they need. And one of the most important things that plants need is CO2. Today, we're gonna do a CO2 carbon dioxide tutorial. Welcome to the beautiful world of aquascaping. So the first step is the bottle, okay? It could be a small one, it could be a huge one. The pressure in this one is around, I would say 50 bars when it's full, but you need to control this 50 bar pressure somehow. And this pressure reducer is the one that is controlling it. And this pressure reducer has another thing, a valve that would control the flow of the CO2. So this has five things on it. The output, I would say number one, but whatever. The output has a ring. See this thing? Never use it without a ring, because the CO2 is a very small particle gas and it will escape and your canister will deplete much, much quicker. So make sure that you have, it could be a rubber one or it could be a plastic one like this one. And what you do is you place it on that. You start to screw it in with your hands. And then, when you can no longer apply pressure, you take a tool and you will continue doing that. Now, this is not cool. Somehow it doesn't go in there. All right, so I'm gonna take this 5 kilogram one. I'm gonna continue on that. It's easier. I think it's enough. Okay, this is enough. And then also, when these pressure reducers arrive to you, this one is loose, see? Screw this on with your hand. Okay, now it's fine. There's two gauges. The one you see on this side is for the high pressure. I'm gonna open the bottle now with this, and you can see that the pressure has already increased, and it's about 50 bars. You don't have to open this tap all the way. I just open it like halfway, maybe a couple of turns, until I've got enough pressure on this. From this point on, make sure that this bottle is not sitting in a horizontal position, because if it does, the liquid carbon dioxide can get into the pressure reducer. It might or might not damage it, so don't do that. So make sure that this whole thing stands on its feet. So you will see how much pressure you have in the bottle on this first indicator. If it starts to go up, it means that the bottle is almost empty and then there's no longer liquid in it. Basically, there's only pressurized gas. And that's why you see in the last days, okay, you're not gonna check this every day, but if you do happen to check it and you see that the pressure is increasing, you don't have just a couple of days left of craft, of stuff in the bottle. The second one is showing the output pressure. The output pressure is zero at this moment. So right now, this whole pressure reducer is stopping the CO2 from going out. What I have to do is I have this black thing at the end. I need to close this actually clockwise. And if I start to close it clockwise, you will see that the pressure starts to increase. See that? I will close it until the outgoing pressure is about, let's say 2.5 bars. Bottle pressure, outgoing pressure, tap or valve to control the outgoing pressure. And then you have the needle valve here. That's the fifth element of this pressure reducer. The needle valve is controlling how much CO2 gets into the system. Third element is the hose. I'm gonna take this hose. I'm gonna take the screw cap that I took off. I'm gonna put it on like this. Don't forget to put it on. And then I'm gonna apply, I'm just gonna push this in. It goes in easy. And then I'm gonna screw this back on. And then you have the first part of the game here. What kind of hose to use? Use CO2 proof hose. Don't use the aeration hose. The difference between these two is that the CO2 hose is a little bit harder to bend. And this is really easy to bend, okay? You see the difference? So this is a aeration hose, not good for CO2, don't use it. Okay, so one step, two step, three steps. The fourth step is connecting the solenoid valve. It's a magnetic valve. So the solenoid valve is just a simple valve that will let the gas through. It has an arrow saying the gas has to come from this direction. I'm the bottle, coming from the bottle, going away from the bottle towards the tank. We need to come from that direction. So what I'm gonna do is unscrew this cap. Make sure that you put this on the hose, connect it to the hose, screw it on. Okay, and then what I usually do before we move on, I connect the next hose, connect this, close it, and we're done. And what I do usually is I take this, and I just hook it onto the top. That's what I usually do. Item number five is the timer. So that was number five. Item number six, we continue with the hose. That goes to the tank, right? Okay, so what's the question about the hose? You have to make sure that the tank water does not get into this guy. It's very important. So before we start moving into the tank, I need to add another step, and that step is number six, check valve. The check valve will prevent the water from flowing back into the solenoid valve, and it could damage it, so don't do that. That one also has a flow indicator. You could see here the arrow is pointing that way, which means that we're coming from the tank from here. So what I'm gonna do, put this on here, right? I have it on, perfect. And then comes item number seven, bubble counter. Bubble counter can be made of acrylic or of glass. What do you fill this guy with? Actually, I would say that it's better to fill this guy with this bubble counter solution. We have a bubble counter solution available at Green Aqua, you can get that. It's heavier than water. The viscosity is heavier. It does nothing to the tank actually when it gets into it. But the problem is that when in the morning this guy will switch on, the higher pressure will push the water out of this guy into the tank because the water is not heavy enough. So you need something to prevent that. And for that, I will just take a very small piece of this. If you have a glass of water, not for drinking, you could get in these two and then just try to put it on. Easier if it's wet. You don't need to push it on too much. Just probably 1 centimeter or less. Okay, so now it's on. Please note that there's a bottom to it, which has this little piece there, and there's a top to it. And you always put the bottom one. So you have a short hose connected to the bottom. And then what you do is you take a syringe that comes with the bubble counter solution. Open this guy, take the hose that comes with it. Take this hose, take some up, and I will connect it to the bottom like that, and then just push it in and push the water out because this had some water in it. Okay, and then you connect it to the check valve, you turn it, you take the top off, and you're done. Okay, so now we're done. But make sure you don't spill it out like I did. I will continue and we'll put on the top. Okay, before I move on, I keep some cleaning on the outside of it. Again, it's not a problem if this gets into water. Just make sure that you don't put any liquid soap again in this. And then as the last step, glass U-shaped stuff hose that would take the gas seamlessly into the tank. I really like this small piece. It's just a connector, so it would bend, because if this hose bends, it will break and it doesn't look good. This one is much, much more neat. So I would recommend you to get this. You can break this really easily, especially when you put the hoses on. And then another piece of hose with a little suction cup, and then the diffuser. Okay, so this is a complete CO2 system. Again, bottle, pressure reducer with a needle valve, hose, solenoid valve, hose, check valve, hose, bubble counter, hose, joint, hose, suction cup, diffuser. That's it. I put it in this water. I'm gonna have this guy visible. I'm gonna put it on top of this so you guys see. Ready? Check this out. Too much, right? So I'm gonna close this completely, and then I'm gonna open this gradually, very slowly, until I get to the desired amount of CO2 that I want to use. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is fine for starters, okay? A little bit quicker than 1 second. This is fine. And as you can see, the bubbles have already started to appear over there, and this would probably be enough. If you think that this is too much, then you close this little needle valve a little bit, and you have to wait for the pressure to equalize. Now it's slowing down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, it's slowing down, but it needs time, so don't rush it. So now it's about almost 1 second. And this would be good for almost all tanks, small tanks. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask them in the comments. I'm ready to help you, and we'll see you on Thursday. Bye.